In the previous video, we learned how to connect to SQL Server using SQL Server Management Studio. Now that we have already connected to the server, it's time to find out how to interact with it. To navigate through servers, databases, and tables, you need Object Explorer, an important tool that allows you to perform a variety of tasks. If you don't see it or accidentally close the window, click View, Object Explorer, or just press F8 key. The window itself can be docked as tab document, left floating, or hidden, depending on your tasks and preferences. By default, it is docked on the left side of SSMS window. Object Explorer can be connected to multiple servers. You can even connect to the same server several times using different credentials, which is sometimes useful to test scripts in different security contexts. The first thing you see in the node tree is the header that consists of SQL Server instance name, version of SQL Server, and the name of the account that you used to connect to it. Remember that Object Explorer displays customized context menu, depending on the node type you have right-clicked. I recommend you to play around with the most common object types and discover the possibilities that Object Explorer offers. Let's have a look at the database node. It contains the list of system and user databases. Context menu of the database node offers the possibility to create empty query window, connected to the right-click database. Let's do this. Once created, query editor window can be used for writing queries. To run the query, press F5 button. The results will be displayed in results grid. If your script returns several result sets, they will be shown each in their own results grid. SSMS executes the entire script by default, but note that any selection will result in executing only the selected part of the script. You can create multiple query editor windows by pressing Ctrl plus N. You can repeat this operation to create as many query windows as you need. Note that SSMS will reuse connection information from the current query editor window when creating a new one. You can use Query, Change Connection if you need to switch the server for the current query, or use Database drop-down on the toolbar to connect to the different database on the same server. Also, Use command can be applied to switch the database context. For example, type Use master and execute it to switch the context to master database. Current connection context of the window is displayed at the bottom of Query Editor and is vital for keeping track of your current connection. You surely don't want to run any test scripts on production databases. Changing connection in Query Editor does not affect connections in Object Explorer. Object Explorer has its separate connection and does not receive any events if you create or delete databases or other database objects using SQL script. That is why almost every node in Object Explorer that has child objects has a refresh command in its context menu to let you monitor the actual state of the server. SSMS has IntelliSense and helps you to write queries by predicting and displaying the list of possible objects or commands that can be used. IntelliSense function is not perfect, but it's getting better with every release. Using aliases helps IntelliSense understand you better and display more relevant suggestions. That is all for today. I hope the tips will help you perform faster and better than you did before. If you want to learn how to work with SSMS query window more effectively, check out our videos about SSMS Boost add-in. Don't forget to share your feedback in the comments below to help us improve this functionality. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.